This is the battlefield for our game of speed and strategy. These are the letters which lead to victory on Blockbusters. And here's the star of Blockbusters, Bill Cullen.
That's me. How are you? Oh, yeah. Hi, players.
Hi, Bill.
Oh, boy. That's all right. Thank you. Thank you very much. Hello, everybody. Welcome to Blockbusters. This is a show where we try to determine, by having a family pair and a solo player, whether or not two heads are indeed better than one, or if a rolling stone gathers moss. We haven't come up with either of those answers yet, but we're going to work at it. We had a whiz-bang of a game going here when time was called last time. It was between our champions, a brother and a sister team. They are Sharon White and her brother, Kevin Gibson, and so far they've won $4,700 plus $552. Congratulations. How are you, Sharon?
Fine, I guess.
You know, you do very well. All through the game, it is Kevin who's popping in there with answers one after the other. And every once in a while, when we least expect it, Forrest and I were talking about this, Sharon comes in with a very important one. Has that been your way through life, Sharon?
I just told everybody I'd get one, and it had to be at the right time so I could say the family name.
You came up with Mr. Magoo's proper first name, and I never knew it was Quincy, right? We got talking about middle names. Do you know your middle name yet, Sharon? You
said
you
didn't. No. I do not know what it is.
May I talk to your brother, Kevin Leonard, now? Hello, Kevin Leonard.
Hello.
How are you?
Scared.
Oh, don't be frightened. You two play this game very well. Now, you're in aerospace, are you not, Sharon? And Kevin, how about you again?
I'm in aerospace also.
Well, two people out of space. No wonder you're having difficulty. Here's our solo player. We just met him last time. He is Forrest Reed. Welcome back, Forrest. Good to have you.
Thank you, Bill.
And you're in what line?
I'm in sales.
In sales.
Right.
Well, you know how it plays. You did pretty well. Actually, at this moment, our family pair is leading this match. They've picked up a game and the $500 that goes with it. And, of course, the first team to win two games wins the match and gets a shot at $5,000 additional on Gold Run. So, Forrest, it's up to you to stop them if you can. You answered correctly. There's our board over there. The red represents our solo player, making a path from top to bottom. White, our family pair, from side to side. You blocked just in time, Forrest, because this is game two, and it's your selection. Where do you want to go?
Let's go to T, Bill.
Okay, let's go to T. Right, that's an English custom, but I'll be happy to join you. Got a T question. That was good. Got a T question here, which means the answer starts with T. Everybody ready? Here comes the question. What P? It's a T question. Check that out there. Here comes the question again. What T does an elephant do? What do you say, Kevin?
Trot.
I'm glad I changed the initial back.
No. Trot. Trot.
Okay, now you hang on because I'm going to read the whole question to you, Forrest. Now, here goes. Forrest, this is yours now. No. What T does an elephant do, or is Doc Severinsen's horn?
Trumpet.
That's it. Better than trot any day. You get it, Forrest. Credit where credit is due, Kevin. That was a good answer. I appreciate it. It gave a chuckle to all and sundry. Well, Forrest, you've come from behind, and look where you are. Where do you want to go now?
Well, we'll have to go to the ultimate C.
Sooner or later, that's the choice. If Forrest gets this one, he wins the game and ties the match. Family pair is trying to block. They already have a game in this match. Here's a question. What C is the kind of car that Chrysler is going to start making again that hasn't been produced by any American company in years? Don't help. Time, the answer is convertible. No American company has made a convertible for a long time. We come up now, another C question. Forrest, you want it. Question, here it comes. What C is a game piece or a supermarket employee? Kevin, the block.
Checker.
Checker is right, and the block's in there, Kevin. Oh, man. Okay, Kevin. Better than trot, I'll tell you. Where are you going?
I could play it safe, but I'm going to go with the P anyway.
Okay, yeah, the P. That's right. But now, you want to block this time, Forrest, right, because if family pair gets it, that's game and match. Question. Answer starts with a P. What P was the location of the Hot Water War, the Whiskey Rebellion, and the Battle of Gettysburg? Forrest.
Pennsylvania.
Correct. You block. Forrest, Pennsylvania answers them all. Where are you going, Forrest?
Let's go to Ian.
An exact change around from the situation a moment ago. The solo player can win it. Family pair wants to block. Possible tie match with this one. Question coming, answer starts with N. What N is the spice which is provided by the evergreen tree? Ken's going to take a chance.
Nutmeg.
Nutmeg is the right answer. You have the block. Nutmeg indeed. Everybody's path gets a little longer. Where to, Kevin?
Let's go with E.
Okay, you see, the E will do it. The E will do it for the family pair. You want to block, Forrest. Question, answer starts with E. What E was the Bavarian flower sung about in The Sound of Music? Kevin, for the game.
Edelweiss.
Edelweiss is right. It's game and match. Congratulations. That was a good game. Very good game, actually. Forrest, you played it well. That's little or no consolation, I know, but you did play the game well, and we do have, speaking of consolation, some very nice consolation prizes for you. Now, you sit right there and be comfortable. Kevin and Sharon, we're going to be back here in a moment, give you two a chance of gold run for another $5,000. But right now, we're going to pause because we have these words we know you want to hear. We have to. While all that was going on that you were watching at home, Kevin and his sister, it's Kevin Gibson and Sharon White, they were having what I guess is a mild argument. I think Kevin was trying to talk Sharon into come up and play Gold Run, because the last thing I heard Kevin said, well, go on up, you can't do any worse than I've done. You want that, huh? All right. Okay. That was the argument as we tuned into it. Well, of course, the thing is, Kevin, yes, Sharon, did you want to say something?
I'm giving him one more chance to do it right before I take over.
But he's the captain, and you have to do what the captain says. Isn't that right?
He gets one more chance before I show him up.
Okay, I have to, for the record, I have to ask the question. Kevin Gibson, captain, sir, which of the two of you are going to come up here and play Gold Run for $5,000 more?
I'm going to go again.
Okay, come on up. I'm going to open my thing here and give you a chance at it. Uh-oh. There it goes. Don't step in there. Cut in half. Couldn't talk her into it, huh, Kevin?
No, couldn't.
Well, you've done all right. You know, with you coming up here, you have $5,700, and you're still playing the game. Quickly, while you catch your breath, I'll explain that Kevin is going to start at the left, make a path connecting the goal to the goal. When he does that, $5,000 goes to an additional $5,000 to the family pair. If you miss, we throw a block up, and you should be able to work your way around it. You've had trouble at the Gold Run board so far, but you do everything else so well. I know it's a matter of just pacing and breathing and things like that. Put 60 seconds up there. Okay, I guess the idea is to try to convince yourself that it's not important. I know how silly that is, because we know it is. We will not start the clock until you are ready to begin and tell me where you want to, Kevin. Good luck to you, and play it cool.
Okay, we'll go with A.R.
Abe Lincoln's first sweetheart.
Pass. A. Z.
The scientific study of animals.
Zoology.
Yes.
E.S.
Where Duarte is president.
El Salvador.
Right.
J.B.
Chicago's mayor.
Jim Beam.
Nope.
O.J.
Another name O.G. for the Stars and Stripes.
Oh, Glory.
Yes.
S.M.
Peter Parker's secret
identity. Spider-Man.
Yes.
L.M.
Sold chicken before he was governor.
Louis Martin. I don't know.
No.
P.T.M.
Friend of little Jackie Paper.
Oh. Jackie Paper. Pop the Magic Dragon.
Yeah.
Oh.
You get it. You brought it in. Yay. Super. Congratulations, Kevin. You brought it in. Go sit down. You got. Oh, if you got. Sharon said, I knew you could do it. What if you had sent me up there? Well, you did. Boy, you really got. You got Puff the Magic Dragon. You hung in there and you brought it home. You now have won an additional $5,000. You're winning so far $10,700. Pretty darn good, you two. There's the board. You lit it up all the way across. Only two blank spots there where you had your trouble. Your first one, your starting one, A.R., Abe Lincoln's first sweetheart, Ann Rutledge.
Yeah, I knew her first name, but not her last.
Yeah. Then you had Chicago's mayor, J.B. You came up with Jim Beam, which is a sensational idea. It's Jane Byrne, though. Jane Byrne. And L.M. sold chicken before he was governor, had the pick handle. Lester Maddox is the one. Okay, you have $10,700. We're going out and find you another solo player to compete with. Meantime, for you folks at home, if you don't mind, we have to pay for this, and here's how we do it. Very good, Kevin. I enjoyed that, Kevin. I enjoyed very much watching you start out having difficulty on that gold run board, and you had it for several times, and finally you got in there, and whatever you did, I don't know, but it worked. You conquered it. Congratulations. That was a good job. $10,700. You two are a darn good family pair. We've gone out and spared no expense at all to find a solo player we think can give you a comeuppance or whatever it is winners are given. Ladies and gentlemen, join me and make welcome June Roars. Welcome, June.
Hello, Bill.
How are you?
I'm just fine, thank you. Scared to death.
You what?
Scared to death.
Are you really? Oh, just don't be frightened of me, because I can't hurt anyone. Those days are gone forever, June. Even then, I didn't scare. What do you do, June?
I'm a housewife, golf and bridge bum.
Oh, yeah?
And love word games, and I have 5 children and a wonderful husband.
Oh, that's very nice. When you said you love word games, Sharon did a big take over there. So are you a little worried about June, are you, Sharon?
Little.
Well, let's see how well you play, June. We wish you well. You know how it works, do you know? Okay, we're all set to start. This game won of the match. First team who wins 2 games or $1,000 wins the match and gets a shot at the gold run for an additional $5,000. Going to start with Z. Oh, down in the corner. I like Z answers. There aren't that many of them, you know. There are more than X, but aren't that many. Answer's going to start with a Z. Everybody ready to go? Soon as you think you know, June, whang that thing.
Okay.
Hit it. Question coming. What Z is a national park in Utah? Well, that's June.
Zion.
And that's right, June. That's the way you play it. See? As they say in most games, it's that first one that puts you over the hill, gets you going. Where are you going, June?
E.
Okay, letter E. Going straight up to make that top-to-bottom connection. Question. What E has the largest and most varied vocabulary of any language in the world? It's June again.
English.
English is the right answer again. You know, could you come close to guessing how many words there are in the English language? Anyone want to take
it?
Huh?
About 3 billion.
No, not that many. Maybe with inflation, yeah, but actually 600,000. Am I not correct that Shakespeare had a vocabulary of 15,000 words? Think about a small portion of that 60,000. Of course, I'm probably wrong, so don't think about it until you check it. Anyway, English was the right answer, June. Where would you like to go?
H.
Letter H. Look at June going up there. Okay, question. What H is a children's game and a Walter Matthau? That is Kevin.
Hopscotch.
Movie. Hopscotch is the answer, Kevin. Family Fair score.
It works.
Where to, Kevin?
Let's go with the P.
Okay, letter P. Question coming, answer starts with P. What P is the fruit that was once known as the Persian plum? June?
Pomegranate.
No, repeat it now for either the family pair. What P is the fruit that was once known as the Persian plum? Kevin?
Pear.
Nope.
Peach.
You got 2 peas in there, but peach.
Peach.
Peach. The peach was once known as the Persian plum. It didn't sell, so they changed it to peach. Advertising agency did that. You know, they do. Question coming. It's another P question. Everybody eligible for this. What P is the word for a worldwide epidemic? Kevin.
Plague.
Nope. Repeat it now for June. What P is the word for a worldwide epidemic?
I can't think of a thing.
Pandemic. Prefix meaning all or everything. Plague can be terrible, but not necessarily worldwide. Pandemic. Well, we come up with another P. My goodness. We're going to run out of them. Oh, we got a bunch of them there. Here's a question. Answer starts with P. What P is the movie that takes place in the mythical seaport of Sweet Haven? Oh. I'm surprised no one knows that. Popeye. We come up with another P question. Oh my goodness. This show has more of those than anything else. Everybody ready? What P is the nut that grows on the turpentine tree? Kevin?
Pecan.
Nope. Repeat it for June now. June, what P is the nut that grows on the turpentine tree and is used to flavor a green-colored ice cream?
Pistachio.
Pistachio is the right answer, and that takes care of the peach. Well, now, look where you are there, June. Oh, June, don't make your choice yet. We'll be back here in just a moment. We have to do some business that brings money into the house. See you in a moment.
Blocks. They're six-sided polygons. But Polygon Busters is much too difficult to say. More Blockbusters is next. Then stick around for Child's.
All right, we're ready to pick it up now. So, June, you had scored correctly, and look how close you're getting. Where are you going this time?
I will have O.
Needless to say, if June comes up with this O answer, the correct one, she wins game one and leads this match. Question coming, of course, Kevin and Sharon want a block. Here's an O question. What O is where the Gillikins, Winkies, Quadlings, and Munchkins live? Kevin.
Oz.
You got the block. Oz is the right answer. Yes, sir. Family pair threw that block in there. Had a good time.
Let's go with T.
The letter T.
Okay. T as in Tom.
See what you're doing. Question coming? Answer starts with T. What T is the slippery surface that DuPont puts on pots? June?
Teflon.
Teflon is right. Pots and pans. Yes, June?
B.
Okay, letter B. You see, her path got a little longer because of that block that Kevin threw. Here comes a B answer question. What B is what lawyers pass, but... Sharon?
Bar.
But drinkers don't. Bar is the answer. Okay, I like that question. Oh, that family pair is... Now they're beginning to make their own tracks. Where to, Sharon?
M.
All right. Answer starts with M. What M precedes mouse? Kevin?
Mickey.
Nope. I repeat it now for June. What M precedes mouse, pearl, and Ripperton?
Minnie.
Minnie is the right answer. Sorry about that, Minnie Ripperton. Well, now, look where you are. You're sort of disconnected there, June, but you can put yourself back together, board-wise.
Yes. I will go for G.
Okay, letter G. That'll make you the top connection. Family pair, of course, wants to block. Here comes the question. What G is the transparent food made by boiling beef bones? Kevin?
Gelatin.
Gelatin is the right answer. You blocked again. Full question, transparent food made by boiling beef bones, cartilage, and tendons. The answer, gelatin. The family pair collects it. And where are you going, Kevin?
I'm going to go with the L.
Time has come. You do want a block now, June. Whatever you do, this is a block you need. Question coming could be a win of the game for the family pair. What L are the crop-destroying insects? Kevin.
Locust.
Locust is right. You won the game. Congratulations. You did a good job there, June. Okay, I'll, that's the family pair, pulled out another one, picked up 500. The full question is, what L are the crop-destroying insects that are said to appear every 7 years? The answer, locust, it was a good interruption. Game one goes to the family pair. They pick up $500 more, and June, you played very well. Do not be discouraged. Really, you got it down there. We'll be back here in just a moment, but right now, we have to do these things. June, Sharon, Kevin, thank you kindly. We have another game to go, at least one, possibly two, to decide this match, so we won't rush it. Instead, we'll give June and Sharon and Kevin a chance to rest. See you all again next time when we're back here. Hope you can make it. I hope I can make it. Anything. Bye.
Some of our contestants will receive Quazero Presents this hand-blown crystal lamp from the Satin Lace Collection, designed to add beauty and warmth to your home exclusively by Quazero. And a selection of Tower books featuring the Gossip Wars by Bill Macklin about the golden age of gossip when columnists could make or break a star. And West Bend's versatile 6-quart automatic slow cooker plus. So cooks, bakes, roasts, grills, and even serves. Non-sticking with colorful porcelain exterior. And new Easy Caulker aerosol foam caulk. No gun, no mess, outlast 4 cartridges. Caulk it easy with Easy Caulker. And Future makes old-looking no-wax floors look young again. That's why Future's recommended for no-wax floors. And get the taste that's looking good. Try Lipton low-calorie iced tea mix with only 2 calories per glass. It's got the taste that's looking good. And a representative of our studio audience will receive Makita's new fast-charge cordless polisher. Ready to polish your car, clean tile, carpet spot, sand, wood, and metal. Furnished by Makita. This is Bob Hilton speaking for Blockbusters, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. This is the battlefield for our game of speed and strategy. These are the letters which lead to victory on Blockbusters. And here's the star of Blockbusters, Bill Todman.
That's me. Oh, that. Hi, players.
Hi, Bill.
Oh, boy. That's all right. Thank you. Thank you very much. Hello, everybody. Welcome to Blockbusters. This is a show where we try to determine, by having a family pair and a solo player, whether or not two heads are indeed better than one, or if a rolling stone gathers moss. We haven't come up with either of those answers yet, but we're going to work at it. We had a whiz-bang of a game going here when time was called last time. It was between our champions, a brother and a sister team. They are Sharon White and her brother, Kevin Gibson, and so far they've won $4,700 plus $552. Congratulations. How are you, Sharon?
Fine, I guess.
You know, you do very well. All through the game, it is Kevin who's popping in there with answers one after the other. And every once in a while, when we least expect it, Forrest and I were talking about this, Sharon comes in with a very important one. Has that been your way through life, Sharon?
I just told everybody I'd get one, and it had to be at the right time so I could say the family name.
You came up with Mr. Magoo's proper first name, and I never knew it was Quincy, right? We got talking about middle names. Do you know your middle name yet, Sharon? You
said
you
didn't. No. I do not know what it is.
May I talk to your brother, Kevin Leonard, now? Hello, Kevin Leonard.
Hello.
How are you?
Oh, scared.
Oh, don't be frightened. You two play this game very well. Now, you're in aerospace, are you not, Sharon? And Kevin, how about you again?
I'm in aerospace also.
Well, two people out of space. No wonder you're having difficulty. Here's our solo player. We just met him last time. He is Forrest Reed. Welcome back, Forrest. Good to have you.
Thank you, Bill.
And you're in what line?
I'm in sales.
In sales.
Right.
Well, you know how it plays. You did pretty well. Actually, at this moment, our family pair is leading this match. They've picked up a game and the $500 that goes with it. And, of course, the first team to win two games wins the match and gets a shot at $5,000 additional on Gold Run. So, Forrest, it's up to you to stop them if you can. You answered correctly. There's our board over there. The red represents our solo player, making a path from top to bottom. White, our family pair, from side to side. You blocked just in time, Forrest, because this is game two, and it's your selection. Where do you want to go?
Let's go to T, Bill.
Okay, let's go to T. Right, that's an English custom, but I'll be happy to join you. Got a T question. That was good. Got a T question here, which means the answer starts with T. Everybody ready? Here comes a question. It's a T question. Check that out there. Here comes the question again. What T does an elephant do? What do you say, Kevin?
Trot.
I'm glad I changed the initial back.
No, no. Trot. Trot.
Okay, now you hang on because I'm going to read the whole question to you, Forrest. Now, two blank spots there where you had your trouble. Your first one, your starting one, A.R., Abe Lincoln's first sweetheart, Ann Rutledge.
Yeah, I knew her first name, but not her last.
Yeah. Then you had Chicago's mayor, J.B. You came up with Jim Beam, which is a sensational idea. It's Jane Byrne, though. Jane Byrne. And L.M. sold chicken before he was governor. Had the pick handle. Lester Maddox is the one. Okay, you have 10,700. We're going out and find you another solo player to compete with. Meantime, for you folks at home, if you don't mind, we have to pay for this, and here's how we do it. Very good, Kevin. I enjoyed that, Kevin. I enjoyed very much watching you start out having difficulty on that gold run board, and you had it for several times, and finally you got in there, and whatever you did, I don't know, but it worked. You conquered it. Congratulations. That was a good job. $10,700. You two are a darn good family pair. We've gone out and spared no expense at all to find a solo player we think can give you a comeuppance or whatever it is winners are given. Ladies and gentlemen, join me and make welcome June Roars. Welcome, June.
Hello, Bill.
How are you?
I'm just fine, thank you. Scared to death.
You what?
Scared to death.
Are you really? Oh, just don't be frightened of me because I can't hurt anyone. Those days are gone forever, June. Even then, I didn't scare. What do you do, June?
I'm a housewife, golf and bridge bum.
Oh, yeah?
And love word games, and I have 5 children and a wonderful husband.
Well, that's very nice. When you said you love word games, Sharon did a big take over there. So are you a little worried about June, are you, Sharon?
Little.
Well, let's see how well you play, June. We wish you well. You know how it works, do you not? Okay, we're all set to start. This game won of the match. First team who wins 2 games or $1,000 wins the match and gets a shot at the gold run for an additional $5,000. Going to start with Z. Oh, down in the corner. I like Z answers. There aren't that many of them, you know. There are more than X, but aren't that many. Answer's going to start with a Z. Everybody ready to go? Soon as you think you know, June, whang that thing. Hit
okay.
It. Question coming. What Z is a national park in Utah? Well, that's June.
Zion.
And that's right, June. That's the way you play it. See? As they say in most games, it's that first one that puts you over the hill, gets you going. Where are you going, June?
E.
Okay, letter E. Going straight up to make that top-to-bottom connection. Question. What E has the largest and most varied vocabulary of any language in the world? It's June again.
English.
English is the right answer again. You know, could you come close to guessing how many words there are in the English language? Anyone want to take
it?
Huh?
About 3 billion.
No, not that many. Maybe with inflation, yeah, but actually 600,000. Am I not correct that Shakespeare had a vocabulary of 15,000 words? Think about a small portion of that 60,000. Of course, I'm probably wrong, so don't think about it until you check it. Anyway, English was the right answer, June. Where would you like to go?
H.
Letter H. Look at June going up there. Okay, here goes. Forrest, this is yours now. No. What T does an elephant do, or is Doc Severinsen's horn?
Trumpet.
That's it. Better than trot any day. You get it, Forrest. Credit where credit is due, Kevin. That was a good answer. I appreciate it. It gave a chuckle to all and sundry. Well, Forrest, you've come from behind, and look where you are. Where do you want to go now?
Well, we'll have to go to the ultimate C.
Sooner or later, that's the choice. If Forrest gets this one, he wins the game and ties the match. Family pair is trying to block. They already have a game in this match. Here's a question. What C is the kind of car that Chrysler is going to start making again that hasn't been produced by any American company in years? Don't help. T. time, the answer is convertible. Mm-hmm. No American company has made a convertible for a long time. We come up now, another C question. Forrest, you want it. Question, here it comes. What C is a game piece or a supermarket employee? Kevin the Block.
Checker.
Checker is right, and the Block's in there, Kevin. Oh, man. Okay, Kevin. Better than trot, I'll tell you. Where are you going?
I could play it safe, but I'm going to go with the P anyway.
Okay, yeah, the P. That's right. But now, you want a block this time, Forrest, right, because if family pair gets it, that's game and match. Question. Answer starts with a P. What P was the location of the Hot Water War, the Whiskey Rebellion, and the Battle of Gettysburg? Forrest.
Pennsylvania.
Correct. You block. Forrest, Pennsylvania answers them all. Where are you going, Forrest?
Let's go to Ian.
An exact change around from the situation a moment ago. The solo player can win it. Family pair wants to block. Possible tie match with this one. Question coming, answer starts with N. What N is the spice which is provided by the evergreen tree? Kevin's going to take a chance.
Nutmeg.
Nutmeg is the right answer. You have the block. Nutmeg indeed. Everybody's path gets a little longer. Where to, Kevin?
Let's go with E.
Okay, you see, the E will do it. The E will do it for the family pair. You want a block, Forrest. Question, answer starts with E. What E was the Bavarian flower sung about in The Sound of Music? Kevin, for the game.
Edelweiss.
Edelweiss is right. It's game and match. Congratulations. That was a good game. Very good game, actually. Forrest, you played it well. That's little or no consolation, I know, but you did play the game well, and we do have, speaking of consolation, some very nice consolation prizes for you. Now, you sit right there and be comfortable. Kevin and Sharon, we're going to be back here in a moment, give you two a chance of gold run for another $5,000. But right now, we're going to pause, because we have these words we know you want to hear. We have to. While all that was going on that you were watching at home, Kevin and his sister, it's Kevin Gibson and Sharon White, they were having what I guess is a mild argument. I think Kevin was trying to talk Sharon into come up and play Gold Run, because the last thing I heard Kevin said, well, go on up, you can't do any worse than I've done. You want that, huh? All right. Okay. That was the argument as we tuned into it. Well, of course, the thing is, Kevin, yes, Sharon, did you want to say something?
I'm giving him one more chance to do it right before I take over.
But he's the captain, and you have to do what the captain says. Isn't that right?
He gets one more chance before I show him up.
Okay, I have to, for the record, I have to ask the question. Kevin Gibson, captain, sir, which of the two of you are going to come up here and play Gold Run for $5,000 more?
I'm going to go again.
Okay, come on up. I'm going to open my thing here and give you a chance at it. Uh-oh. There it goes. Don't step in there. Cut in half. Couldn't talk her into it, huh, Kevin?
No, couldn't.
Well, you've done all right. You know, with you coming up here, you have $5,700, and you're still playing the game. Quickly, while you catch your breath, I'll explain that Kevin is going to start at the left, make a path connecting the gold to the gold. When he does that, $5,000 goes to an additional $5,000 to the family pair. If you miss, we throw a block up, and you should be able to work your way around it. You've had trouble at the Gold Run board so far, but you do everything else so well. I know it's a matter of just pacing and breathing and things like that. Put 60 seconds up there. Okay, I guess the idea is to try to convince yourself that it's not important. I know how silly that is, because we know it is. We will not start the clock until you are ready to begin and tell me where you want to, Kevin. Good luck to you, and play it cool.
Okay, we'll go with AR.
Abe Lincoln's first sweetheart.
Pass. A Z.
The scientific study of animals.
Zoology.
Yes.
ES.
Where Duarte is president.
El Salvador.
Right.
JB.
Chicago's mayor.
Jim Beam.
Nope.
OJ.
Another name for the Stars and Stripes.
Oh, Glory.
Yes.
SM.
Peter Parker's secret
identity. Spider-Man.
Yes.
LM.
Sold chicken before he was governor.
Louis Martin, I don't know.
Nope.
PTM.
Friend of little Jackie Paper.
Oh. Jackie Paper. Pop the magic dragon!
Yeah!
Oh.
You did it! You brought it in! Yay! Super! Congratulations, Kevin. You brought it in. Go sit down, you got. Oh, if you got. Sharon said, I knew you could do it. What if you had sent me up there? Well, you did. Boy, you really got. You got Puff the Magic Dragon. You hung in there and you brought it home. You now have won an additional $5,000. You're winning so far $10,700. Pretty darn good, you two. There's the board. You lit it up all the way across. Only two. Only question. What H is a children's game and a Walter Matthau? That is Kevin.
Hopscotch.
Movie. Hopscotch is the answer. Kevin, Family Fair score.
It works.
Where to, Kevin?
Let's go with the P.
Okay, letter P. Question coming, answer starts with P. What P is the fruit that was once known as the Persian plum? June?
Pomegranate.
No, repeat it now for either the family pear. What P is the fruit that was once known as the Persian plum? Kevin?
Pear.
Nope.
Peach.
You got two P's in there, but peach.
Peach.
Peach. The peach was once known as the Persian plum. It didn't sell, so they changed it to peach. Advertising agency did that. You know they do. Question coming. It's another P question. Everybody eligible for this. What P is the word for a worldwide epidemic? Kevin.
Plague.
Nope. Repeat it now for June. What P is the word for a worldwide epidemic?
I can't think of a thing. Can't
think pandemic.
Pandemic.
Prefix meaning all or everything.
Right.
Plague can be terrible, but not necessarily worldwide. Pandemic. Well, we come up with another P. My goodness. We're going to run out of them. Oh, we got a bunch of them there. Here's a question. Answer starts with P. What P is the movie that takes place in the mythical seaport of Sweet Haven? Oh. I'm surprised no one knows that. Popeye. Popeye. We come up with another P question.
It's going to
oh my goodness. This show has more of those than anything else. Everybody ready? What P is the nut that grows on the turpentine tree? Kevin?
Pecan.
Nope. Repeat it for June now. June, what P is the nut that grows on the turpentine tree and is used to flavor a green-colored ice cream?
Pistachio.
Pistachio is the right answer, and that takes care of the peach. Well, now, look where you are there, June. Oh, June, don't make your choice yet. We'll be back here in just a moment. We'll have to do some business that brings money into the house. See you in a moment.
Blocks. They're six-sided polygons. But Polygon Busters is much too difficult to say. More Blockbusters is next. Then stick around for Child's.
All right, we're ready to pick it up now. So, June, you had scored correctly, and look how close you're getting. Where are you going this time?
I will have O.
Needless to say, if June comes up with this O answer, the correct one, she wins game one and leads this match. Question coming, of course, Kevin and Sharon want a block. Here's an O question. What O is where the Gillikens, Winkies, Quadlings, and Munchkins live? Kevin.
Oz.
You got the block. Oz is the right answer. Yes, sir. Family Fair threw that block in there. Had a good time.
Let's go with T.
The letter T.
Okay. T as in Tom.
See what you do. An additional $5,000 to the family pair. If you miss, we throw a block up, and you should be able to work your way around it. You've had trouble at the goal run board so far, but you do everything else so well. I know it's a matter of just pacing and breathing and things like that. Put 60 seconds up there. Okay, I guess the idea is to try to convince yourself that it's not important. I know how silly that is, because we know it is. We will not start the clock until you are ready to begin and tell me where you want to, Kevin. Good luck to you, and play it cool.
Okay, we'll go with A.R.
Abe Lincoln's first sweetheart.
Pass. A Z.
The scientific study of animals.
Zoology.
Yes.
E-S.
Where Duarte is president.
El Salvador.
Right.
J.B.
Chicago's mayor.
Jim Beam.
Nope.
O.J.
Another name O-G. For the Stars and Stripes.
Oh, glory.
Yes.
S.M.
Peter Parker's secret
identity. Spider-Man.
Yes.
L.M.
Sold chicken before he was governor.
Louis Martin. I don't know.
No.
PTM.
Friend of little Jackie Paper.
Oh. Jackie Paper. Pop the magic dragon.
Yeah.
Oh.
You did it. You brought it in. Yay. Super. Congratulations, Kevin. You brought it in. Go sit down, you got. Oh, if you got. Sharon said, I knew you could do it. What if you had sent me up there? Well, you did. Boy, you really got. You got Puff the Magic Dragon. You hung in there and you brought it home. You now have won an additional $5,000. You're winning so far $10,700. Pretty darn good, you two. As a board, you lit it up all the way across. Only two. Only question. What H is a children's game and a Walter Matthau? That is Kevin.
Hopscotch.
Movie. Works. Hopscotch is the answer. Kevin, Family Fair score.
It works.
Where to, Kevin?
Let's go with the P.
Okay, letter P. Question coming, answer starts with P. What pea is the fruit that was once known as the Persian plum? June?
Pomegranate.
No, repeat it now for either the family pear. What pea is the fruit that was once known as the Persian plum? Kevin?
Pear.
Nope.
Peach.
You got two peas in there, but peach.
Peach.
Oh, peach. The peach was once known as the Persian plum. It didn't sell, so they changed it to peach. Advertising agency did that. You know they do. Question coming. It's another P question. Everybody eligible. We're going out and find you another solo player to compete with. Meantime, for you folks at home, if you don't mind, we have to pay for this, and here's how we do it. Very good, Kevin. I enjoyed that, Kevin. I enjoyed very much watching you start out having difficulty on that gold run board, and you had it for several times, and finally you got in there, and whatever you did, I don't know, but it worked. You conquered it. Congratulations. That was a good job. $10,700. You two are a darn good family pair. We've gone out and spared no expense at all to find a solo player we think can give you a comeuppance or whatever it is winners are given. Ladies and gentlemen, join me and make welcome June Roars. Welcome, June.
Hello, Gil.
How are you?
I'm just fine, thank you. Scared to death.
You what?
Scared to death.
Are you really? Oh, just don't be frightened of me, because I can't hurt anyone. Those days are gone forever, June. Even then, I didn't scare. What do you do, June?
I'm a housewife, golf and bridge bum.
Oh, yeah?
And love word games, and I have 5 children and a wonderful husband.
Well, that's very nice. When you said you love word games, Sharon did a big take over there. So you a little worried about June, are you, Sharon?
Little.
Well, let's see how well you play, June. We wish you well. You know how it works, do you not? Okay, we're all set to start. This game won of the match. First team who which wins 2 games or $1,000 wins the match and gets a shot at the goal run for an additional $5,000. Going to start with Z. Oh, down in the corner. I like Z answers. There aren't that many of them, you know. There are more than X, but aren't that many. Answer's going to start with a Z. Everybody ready to go? Soon as you think you know, June, whang that thing.
Okay.
Hit it. Question coming. What Z is a national park in Utah? Well, that's June.
Zion.
And that's right, June. That's the way you play it. See? As they say in most games, it's that first one that puts you over the hill, gets you going. Where are you going, June?
E.
Okay, letter E. Going straight up to make that top-to-bottom connection. Question. What E has the largest and most varied vocabulary of any language in the world? It's June again.
English.
English is the right answer again. You know, Could you come close to guessing how many words there are in the English language?
Anyone want to take it?
Huh?
About 3 billion.
No, no, not that many. Maybe with inflation, yeah, but actually 600,000. Am I not correct that Shakespeare had a vocabulary of 15,000 words? Think of what a small portion of that 60,000. Of course, I'm probably wrong, so don't think about it until you check it. Anyway, English was the right answer, June. Where would you like to go?
H.
Letter H. Look at June going up there. Congratulations, Kevin. You brought it in. Go sit down. You got. Oh, if you got. Sharon said, I knew you could do it. What if you had sent me up there? Well, you did. Boy, you really got. You got Puff the Magic Dragon. You hung in there and you brought it home. You now have won an additional $5,000. You're winning so far $10,700. Pretty darn good, you two. There's the board. You lit it up all the way across. Only two blank spots there where you had your trouble. Your first one, your starting one, A.R., Abe Lincoln's first sweetheart, Ann Rutledge.
Yeah, I knew her first name, but not her last.
Yeah. Then you had Chicago's mayor, J.B. You came up with Jim Beam, which is a sensational idea. It's Jane Byrne, though. Jane Byrne. And L.M. sold chicken before he was governor, had the pick handle. Lester Maddox is the one. Okay, you have 10,700. We're going out and find you another solo player to compete with. Meantime, for you folks at home, if you don't mind, we have to pay for this, and here's how we do it. Very good, Kevin. I enjoyed that, Kevin. I enjoyed very much watching you start out having difficulty on that gold run board, and you had it for several times, and finally you got in there, and whatever you did, I don't know, but it worked. You conquered it. Congratulations. That was a good job. $10,700. You two are a darn good family pair. We've gone out and spared no expense at all to find a solo player we think can give you a comeuppance or whatever it is winners are given. Ladies and gentlemen, join me and make welcome June Roars. Welcome, June.
Hello, Bill.
How are you?
I'm just fine, thank you. Scared to death.
You what?
Scared to death.
Are you really? Oh, just don't be frightened of me, because I can't hurt anyone. Those days are gone forever, June. Even then, I didn't scare. What do you do, June?
I'm a housewife, golf and bridge bum.
Oh, yeah?
And love word games, and I have 5 children and a wonderful husband.
Oh, that's very nice. When you said you love word games, Sharon did a big take over there. So are you a little worried about June, are you, Sharon?
Little.
Well, let's see how well you play, June. We wish you well. You know how it works, do you know? Okay, we're all set to start. This game won of the match. First team who wins 2 games or $1,000 wins the match and gets a shot at the gold run for an additional $5,000. Going to start with Z. Oh, down in the corner. I like Z answers. There aren't that many of them, you know. There are more than X, but aren't that many. Answer's going to start with a Z. Everybody ready to go? Soon as you think you know, June, whang that thing.
Okay. Hit it.
Question coming. What Z is a national park in Utah? Well, that's June.
Zion.
Puff the Magic Dragon. You hung in there and you brought it home. You now have won an additional $5,000. You're winning so far $10,700. Pretty darn good, you two. There's the board. You lit it up all the way across. Only question. What H is a children's game and a Walter Matthau? That is Kevin.
Hopscotch.
Movie. Hopscotch is the answer. Kevin, family fair score.
It works.
Where to, Kevin?
Let's go with the P.
Okay, letter P. Question coming, answer starts with P. What P is the fruit that was once known as the Persian plum? June?
Pomegranate.
No, repeat it now for either the family pear. What pea is the fruit that was once known as the Persian plum? Kevin.
Pear.
Nope.
Peach.
You got 2 peas in there, but peach.
Peach.
Peach. The peach was once known as a Persian plum. It didn't sell, so they changed it to peach. Advertising agency did that. You know they do. Question coming. It's another pea question. Everybody eligible for this. What pea is the word for a worldwide epidemic? Kevin.
Plague.
Nope. Repeat it now for June. What P is the word for a worldwide epidemic?
can't think of a thing. Can't think
pandemic.
Pandemic.
Prefix meaning all or everything. Plague can be terrible, but not necessarily worldwide. Pandemic. Well, we come up with another P. My goodness. We're going to run out of them. Oh, we got a bunch of them there. Here's a question. Answer starts with P. What P is the movie that takes place in the mythical seaport of Sweet Haven? Oh, I'm surprised no one knows that. Popeye. We come up with another P question.
It's going to open.
My goodness. This show has more of those than anything else. Everybody ready? What P is the nut that grows on the turpentine tree? Kevin?
Pecan.
Nope. Repeat it for June now. June, what P is the nut that grows on the turpentine tree and is used to flavor a green-colored ice cream?
Pistachio.
Pistachio is the right answer, and that takes care of the peas. Well, now, look where you are there, June. Oh, June, don't make your choice yet. We'll be back here in just a moment. We'd have to do some business that brings money into the house. See you in a moment.
Blocks. They're six-sided polygons, but Polygon Busters is much too difficult to say. More blockbusters.
We think can give you a comeuppance or whatever it is winners are given. Ladies and gentlemen, join me and make welcome June Roars. Welcome, June.
Hello, Bill.
How are you?
I'm just fine, thank you. Scared to death.
You what?
Scared to death.
Are you really? Oh, just don't be frightened of me, because I can't hurt anyone. Those days are gone forever, June. Even then, I didn't scare. What do you do, June?
I'm a housewife, golf and bridge bum.
Oh, yeah?
And love word games, and I have 5 children and a wonderful husband.
Well, that's very nice. When you said you love word games, Sharon did a big take over there. So you a little worried about June, are you, Sharon?
Little.
Well, let's see how well you play, June. We wish you well. You know how it works, do you not? Okay, we're all set to start. This game won of the match. First team who wins 2 games or $1,000 wins the match and gets a shot at the goal run for an additional $5,000. Going to start with Z. Oh, down in the corner. I like Z answers. There aren't that many of them, you know. There are more than X, but aren't that many. Answer's going to start with a Z. Everybody ready to go? Soon as you think you know, June, whang that thing. Hit it. Question coming. What Z is a national park in Utah? Well, that's June.
Zion.
And that's right, June. That's the way you play it. See? As they say in most games, it's that first one that puts you over the hill, gets you going. Where are you going, June?
E.
Okay, letter E. Going straight up to make that top-to-bottom connection. Question. What E has the largest and most varied vocabulary of any language in the world? It's June again.
English.
English is the right answer again. You know, could you come close to guessing how many words there are in the English language? Anyone want to take
it?
Huh?
About 3 billion.
No, not that many. Maybe with inflation, yeah, but actually 600,000. Am I not correct that Shakespeare had a vocabulary of 15,000 words? Think about a small portion of that 60,000. Of course, I'm probably wrong, so don't think about it until you check it. Anyway, English was the right answer, June. Where would you like to go?
H.
Letter H. Look at June going up there. Okay, here goes. Forrest, this is yours now. What T does an elephant do, or is Doc Severinsen's horn?
Trumpet.
That's it. Better than trot any day. You get it, Forrest. Credit where credit is due, Kevin. That was a good answer. I appreciate it. It gave a chuckle to all and sundry. Well, Forrest, you've come from behind, and look where you are. Where do you want to go now?
Well, we'll have to go to the ultimate C.
Sooner or later, that's the choice. If Forrest gets this one, he wins the game and ties the match. Talking about middle names, do you know your middle name yet, Sharon? You
said
you
didn't. No. I do not know what it is.
May I talk to your brother, Kevin Leonard, now? Hello, Kevin Leonard.
Hello.
How you?
Oh, scared.
Oh, don't be frightened. You two play this game very well. Now, you're in aerospace, are you not, Sharon? And Kevin, how about you again?
I'm in aerospace also.
Well, two people out of space. No wonder you're having difficulty. Here's our solo player. We just met him last time. He is Forrest Reed. Welcome back, Forrest.
Good to have you. Thank you, Bill.
And you're in what line?
I'm in sales.
In sales.
Right.
Well, you know how it plays. You did pretty well. Actually, at this moment, our family pair is leading this match. They've picked up a game and the $500 that goes with it. And, of course, the first team to win two games wins the match and gets a shot at $5,000 additional on Gold Run. So, Forrest, it's up to you to stop them if you can. You answered correctly. There's our board over there. The red represents our solo player making a path from top to bottom. White, our family pair from side to side. You blocked just in time, Forrest, because this is game two, and it's your selection. Where do you want to go?
Let's go to T, Bill.
Okay, let's go to T. Right, that's an English custom, but I'll be happy to join you. Got a T question. That was good. Got a T question here, which means the answer starts with T. Everybody ready? Here comes the question. What P? It's a T question. Check that out there. Here comes the question again. What T does an elephant do? What do you say, Kevin?
Trot.
I'm glad I changed the initial back.
No, no. Trot. Trot.
Okay, now you hang on because I'm going to read the whole question to you, Forrest. Now, two blank spots there where you had your trouble. Your first one, your starting one, A.R., Abe Lincoln's first sweetheart, Ann Rutledge.
Yeah, I knew her first name, but not her last.
Yeah. Then you had Chicago's mayor, J.B. You came up with Jim Beam, which is a sensational idea. It's Jane Byrne, though. Jane Byrne. And L.M. sold chicken before he was governor, had the pick handle. Lester Maddox is the one. Okay, you have 10,700. We're going out and find you another solo player to compete with. Meantime, for you folks at home, if you don't mind, we have to pay for this, and here's how we do it. Very good, Kevin. I enjoyed that, Kevin. I enjoyed very much watching you start out having difficulty on that Gold Run board, and you had it for several times, and finally you got in there, and whatever you did, I don't know, but it worked. You conquered it. Congratulations. That was a good job. $10,700. You two are a darn good family pair. We've gone out and spared no expense at all to find a solo player we think can give you a comeuppance or whatever it is winners are given. Ladies and gentlemen, join me and make welcome June and the Battle of Gettysburg. Forrest.
Pennsylvania.
Correct. You blocked. Forrest, Pennsylvania answers them all. Where are you going, Forrest?
Let's go to N.
An exact change around from the situation a moment ago. The solo player can win it. Family pair wants to block. Possible tie match with this one. Question coming, answer starts with N. What N is the spice which is provided by the evergreen tree? Kevin's going to take a chance.
Nutmeg.
Nutmeg is the right answer. You have the block. Nutmeg indeed. Everybody's path gets a little longer. Where to, Kevin?
Let's go with E.
Okay, you see, the E will do it. The E will do it for the family pair. You want a block, Forrest. Question, answer starts with E. What E was the Bavarian flower sung about in The Sound of Music? Kevin, for the game.
Edelweiss.
Edelweiss is right. It's game and match. Congratulations. That was a good game. Very good game, actually. Forrest, you played it well. That's little or no consolation, I know, but you did play the game well, and we do have, speaking of consolation, some very nice consolation prizes for you. Now, you sit right there and be comfortable. Kevin and Sharon, we're going to be back here in a moment, give you two a chance of Gold Run for another $5,000. But right now, we're going to pause because we have these words we know you want to hear. We have to. While all that was going on that you were watching at home, Kevin and his sister, it's Kevin Gibson and Sharon White, they were having what I could guess is a mild argument. I think Kevin was trying to talk Sharon into come up and play Gold Run, because the last thing I heard Kevin said, well, go on up, you can't do any worse than I've done. You want that, huh? All right. Okay. That was the argument as we tuned into it. Well, of course, the thing is, Kevin, yes, Sharon, did you want to say something?
I'm giving him one more chance to do it right before I take over.
But he's the captain, and you have to do what the captain says. Isn't that right?
He gets one more chance before I show him up.
Okay, I have to, for the record, I have to ask the question. Kevin Gibson, captain, sir, which of the two of you are going to come up here and play Gold Run for $5,000 more?
I'm going to go again.
Okay, come on up. I'm going to open my thing here and give you a chance at it. Uh-oh. There it goes. Don't step in there. You cut in half. Couldn't talk her into it, huh, Kevin?
No, couldn't.
Well, you've done all right. You know, with you coming up here, you have $5,700, and you're still playing the game. Quickly, while you catch your breath, I'll explain that Kevin is going to start at the left, make a path. Can don't be frightened of me, because I can't hurt anyone. Those days are gone forever, June. Even then, I didn't scare. What do you do, June?
I'm a housewife, golf and bridge bum.
Oh, yeah?
And love word games, and I have 5 children and a wonderful husband.
Well, that's very nice. When you said you love word games, Sharon did a big take over there. So are you a little worried about June, are you, Sharon?
Little.
Well, let's see how well you play, June. We wish you well. You know how it works, do you not? Okay, we're all set to start. This game, one of the match. First team who wins 2 games or $1,000 wins the match and gets a shot at the Gold Run for an additional $5,000. Going to start with Z. Oh, down in the corner. I like Z answers. There aren't that many of them, you know. There are more than X, but aren't that many. Answer's going to start with a Z. Everybody ready to go? Soon as you think you know, June, whang that thing.
Okay.
Hit it. Question coming. What Z is a national park in Utah? Well, that's June.
Zion.
And that's right, June. That's the way you play it. See? As they say in most games, it's that first one that puts you over the hill, gets you going. Where are you going, June?
E.
Okay, letter E. Going straight up to make that top-to-bottom connection. Question. What E has the largest and most varied vocabulary of any language in the world? It's June again.
English.
English is the right answer again. You know, could you come close to guessing how many words there are in the English language? Anyone want to take
it?
Huh?
About 3 billion.
No, not that many. Maybe with inflation, yeah, but actually 600,000. Am I not correct that Shakespeare had a vocabulary of 15,000 words? Think about a small portion of that 60,000. Of course, I'm probably wrong, so don't think about it until you check it. Anyway, English was the right answer, June. Where would you like to go?
H.
Letter H. Look at June going up there. Okay, question. What H is a children's game and a Walter Matthau? That is Kevin.
Hopscotch.
Movie. Works. Hopscotch is the answer, Kevin. Family Fair score.
It works.
Where to, Kevin?
Let's go with the P.
Okay, letter P. Question coming, answer starts with P. What P is the fruit that was once known as the Persian plum? June?
Pomegranate.
No, repeat it now for either the family pair. What P is the fruit that was once known as the Persian plum? Kevin?
Pear.
Nope.
Peach.
You got 2 peas in there, but peach.
Peach.
Peach. The peach was once known as the Persian plum. It didn't sell, so they changed it to peach. Advertising agency did that. You know they do. Question coming. It's been
Locust.
Locust is right. You won the game. Congratulations. You did a good job there, June. Okay, that's the family pair. Pulled out another one, picked up 500. The full question is, what L are the crop-destroying insects that are said to appear every 7 years? The answer, locust, it was a good interruption. Game one goes to the family pair. They pick up $500 more, and June, you played very well. Do not be discouraged. Really, you got it down there. We'll be back here in just a moment, but right now we have to do these things. June, Sharon, Kevin, thank you kindly. We have another game to go, at least one, possibly two, to decide this match, so we won't rush it. Instead, we'll give June and Sharon and Kevin a chance to rest. See you all again next time when we're back here. Hope you can make it. I hope I can make it. Anything. Bye.
Some of our contestants will receive Quazero presents this hand-blown crystal lamp from the satin lace collection designed to add beauty and warmth to your home exclusively by Quazero. And a selection of Tower books featuring the gossip wars by Bill Macklin about the golden age of gossip when columnists could make or break a star. And West Bend's versatile six-quart automatic slow cooker plus. Slow cooks, bakes, roasts, grills, and even serves. Non-sticking with colorful porcelain exterior. And new Easy Caulker aerosol foam caulk. No gun, no mess, outlasts four cartridges. Caulk it easy with Easy Caulker. And Future makes old-looking Nomax floors look young again. That's why Future's recommended for Nomax floors. And get the taste that's looking good. Try a Lipton low-calorie iced tea mix with only 2 calories per glass. It's got the taste that's looking good. And a representative of our studio audience will receive Makita's new fast-charge cordless polisher. Ready to polish your car, clean tile, carpet spot, sand, wood, and metal. Furnished by Makita. This is Bob Hilton speaking for Blockbusters, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. This is the battlefield for our game of speed and strategy. These are the letters which lead to victory on Blockbusters. And here's the star of Blockbusters, Bill Todman.
That's great. Oh, yeah. Hi, players.
Hi, Bill.
Oh, boy. That's all right. Thank you. Thank you very much. Hello, everybody. Welcome to Blockbusters. This is a show where we try to determine, by having a family pair and a solo player, whether or not two heads are indeed better than one, or if a rolling...